So it's like that, huh?
Yes.
Okay. Whoops. So our very special guest in the studio today is Miss Kunya Nix. And she started her career in the financial business. She's worked a lot with small businesses, and she assists with payroll management and payroll processing services. Mm-hmm. Now, without looking at the bio here, because, you know, she's going to tell us some of this. Mm-hmm. Now, Kunya has been working with small businesses to help them with their system. She also assists them with an automated software system to manage their payroll system, which we think is great. She's partnered with a lot of great businesses within the community, and she's been an expert in the landscape of payroll within small businesses. So we're going to go ahead and bring in our very special guest, Miss Kunya Nix, to tell us a little bit about payroll, and she's also going to talk about benefits that small businesses need to think about when running their business. So welcome to the Business Zone, Kunya.
Thank you both for having me. It's nice to be
here.
You're
welcome. You're welcome. This is definitely a part that's needed within small business. This is a part that many small businesses, they don't want to talk about it. Right. They don't want to think about it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So maybe you can help us to enlighten our listeners and viewers on why is this portion of your business so critical?
Yes, sure. I want to attack a myth with payroll. Mm-hmm. People believe you need to be a big company, you need to be a big corporation, or have a lot of cash flow to use a payroll firm or even a payroll consultant. And that is not true. Payroll firms, they pay employees. We also pay business owners. Mm-hmm. We file your quarterly taxes and your annual taxes, and we help you stay compliant in those areas. So one of the biggest myths is, you know, you need to be a big firm. You don't have to be, and it's necessary on all levels.
On all levels.
With one employee, 150 employees, payroll is necessary on all levels.
And those 1099s that we were talking about, that's going to be needed at the end of this year, that's something that your organization helped with as well.
And I'm so glad you addressed that first.
Yes.
Because all of my friends are entrepreneurs, and most of them are under the assumption, oh, it's only me. But as a small business, you want to still get a check from your corporation, per se, so that you can file taxes the right way and also have a covering.
Yes.
So, I'm so glad you said that.
Yes.
Absolutely. And with payroll, we have the option to pay you weekly, bi-weekly, which is every other Friday, every other Monday, or semi-monthly. You pick 2 days out of the month. Mm-hmm. And there's also a quarterly and annual options.
Okay.
So for those small business owners that don't process checks every week or every month, there's a quarterly and annual option. And with that, we'll file their quarterly returns and their annual tax returns, even if it's something called a zero return. Mm. They didn't pay any wages to themselves or their employees, the firms will actually file a zero return
on
their
behalf. Are you
serious?
Okay.
That's amazing, because a lot of small businesses, they don't know that. Now, the payroll system that you develop and provide support services for, is it primarily for LLCs and corporations, or do sole proprietorships can participate in that as well?
Absolutely. Sole proprietors can participate. So I'm a consultant for a few boutique firms based here in Los Angeles, as well as national firms. One of the national firms I can name is ADP. They're a huge payroll firm.
Right.
So depending on the client's need, I work with the firm and the client to make sure that we cover those needs. And it can be anything from payroll, timekeeping, or labor law compliance.
Wow.
So you have some firms that just process checks and others give you more robust services.
So even if you're not making a lot of money, you're a small company, you could be a big company and not be making a lot of money.
Absolutely.
So you still suggest to use a payroll company for some
Absolutely.
To process that. Even if it's I'm not collecting a check weekly. So what benefit would you be to me if I'm not generating any income?
Filing your quarterly returns to the IRS. So payroll, we take over a power of attorney and we communicate to the IRS on your behalf, and we're able to file your tax returns and in some case help you with tax audits.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So in this case, even if you're not making any money, the IRS still wants to know if you're paying wages to yourself or someone else. And if you're not, then of course we'll file a zero return on your behalf.
And a big reason why that is so critical and so important, because many of us small businesses, we said, when it comes to filing our taxes, we'll just do this once a year. So we don't do the quarterly filings.
Absolutely.
And that's where the Social Security tax hit us big time.
Yes.
That's my biggest enemy. That's my biggest enemy as a small business owner. I hate that Social Security guy because he's always coming down at the end of the year and taking so much money out of my taxes.
Absolutely, but it's necessary.
It is.
A lot of small business owners, if we've been an entrepreneur or even a 1099 employee, we don't pay into certain taxes.
Mm-hmm.
We don't pay into disability taxes or SDI or Social Security. So in this case, it allows you to create a pool of money for yourself later just by paying those quarterly or annual taxes.
So then you don't have to pay that big lump sum at the end of the year.
Absolutely.
Right. Definitely. Absolutely. Definitely. Wow. Now, how do people get a hold of you? How do they... how did they set up an appointment with you to talk about that?
Sure. So I am based here in LA. Mm-hmm. I'm actually based out of Pasadena, California. Mm-hmm. However, I have clients. I travel all the way to Bakersfield.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm based here in Los Angeles, and my email address is Kunya, K-U-N-Y-A, at Nix Consulting, and that's N-I-X is an x-ray, consultingla.com.
Right.
Kunya at NixConsultingLA.com.
Is there a phone number that they can reach
you at? Yes, they can. My direct line, in which I'm open to share, is 818-679-5240. 818-679-5240.
Now, Kunya, you also offer other services like health insurance and disability products.
Mm-hmm.
And I just found out from a good friend of mine how important disability is. He's a hairstylist.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Recently had major surgery.
Mm-hmm.
His mother talked him into getting disability insurance. And during that surgery, he had no idea that his insurance company was going to step in and help assist him. He understood it, but he really didn't understand until he got the check.
Yeah.
After sitting at home for about, 3 months of recovery and got the check. And then after he thought he had gotten all the money he could get, he found out, you had 6 months of benefits there, and they end up paying him the whole full out.
Mm.
And then he got an unexpected check, and again, it was a blessing. So explain how important it is for disability insurance, because, we need to know.
I am so happy you brought that up in this particular product.
Yeah.
One, disability is something we don't know we need it until you need it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's one of those things most people hear of Aflac, and Aflac is usually through a big corporation or organization, and it's voluntary benefit. However, I offer individual disability products that can come out your checkings or savings account. It does not have to be payroll deducted.
Mm.
And with that, it allows you reserves or savings in case of accident or illness.
Okay.
So there's a waiting period to state disability. In most cases, entrepreneurs, hairdressers is a really good case.
Yes.
They don't qualify or pay into state disability in some cases. This insurance will step in as a supplemental income. So we actually sell it as income protection insurance.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And it helps you protect your income. We'll give you sometimes a year, two, three years in disability benefits should you have to go out on surgery, accident, or illness. So very important.
You and the client sit down to determine how much they should put away based on the amount of based on their, revenue or what their, I forget it's a term.
So there are two type of products for a business owner. There's business overhead, which will cover your overhead, and that's a little bit more technical than a straight disability product.
Okay.
Disability product is based off your income.
Okay.
And the insurance carriers will step in and give you a percentage of your income after a particular waiting period. That waiting period is 30 days, 60 days.
Okay.
So while I'm sitting with the client, I honestly want to find out how many reserves, how long can they afford to not receive a paycheck? In some case, when we live in Los Angeles, it's no longer than 30 days.
Mm-hmm.
We depend on our paychecks.
Yeah.
So
I can't miss a week.
Exactly.
And one of the beauties that I love about the disability program is not only does it pay you, it provides you a paycheck if you're hurt, but it also pays your bills.
Right.
Yes.
So I love that as a small business and as an entrepreneur.
Exactly. So with that income, there's no restrictions to what you can do. It will help you supplement medical bills. Some people have a lot of out-of-pocket costs with their medical coverage.
Mm-hmm.
In disability policies, there's hospital riders. So mm-hmm. we'll cover you for, you know, so many days right. in the hospital. Yeah. And there's different type of policies out there. But that's why I love what I do. Everything is, seems to be customized yeah. based yeah. on the client's needs. And that goes with insurance benefits and payroll.
So right. I just got a phone call yesterday from one of those companies that claim they're trying to sell health insurance.
Yeah.
And they mentioned that, you know how you have to do that open enrollment mm-hmm. like every 6 months?
The 15th is coming.
Yeah.
The 15th open enrollment.
Now they're changing that a little bit where they're giving you the option that once you enrolled right now, you're good for 3 years mm-hmm. instead of 6 months and then another 6 months. So have you heard about that?
So, yes, that is not my specialty. Although I do specialize in individual coverage, uh-huh. I work directly with the carriers. Uh-huh. And those rates change every
yeah.
year.
Yeah.
And they're not predictable.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So what's happening, you have some mini medical plans mm-hmm. or some fixed plans mm-hmm. that are they're producing. And they're locking you in for a certain period of time. I think with health insurance, it's really unpredictable market. Mm-hmm. So I'm sticking to the Anthems, the right. Kaisers,
right.
To where there's somewhat your out-of-pocket cost is right. least predictable for the next year for yourself and
right.
your family.
Right.
So just the companies that are yeah, pretty prominent.
I'm a little nervous yeah. about being locked in for 3 years.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Because you become unhappy with your kit, with your
well,
company.
The only advantage I think that has to the user is that if they quote you a price right now, mm-hmm. then you're locked in at that
so
price.
So they're doing
for 3 years.
Health insurance that way.
Yes,
now, yes,
yes. So I'm not sure if it's a benefit yet because to me the insurance is just like going to Vegas, you know, they're playing the casino.
Yeah.
Because the house always wins. So I'm trying to figure
that's
out.
That's
okay,
our mortgage, car insurance.
Yeah, exactly.
The house always wins.
So I'm trying to figure out, okay, what's the scheme? What's the strategy
right.
here? Why are they offering
right.
it? What's in it for me?
There's only one thing I'm sure of is that I need a PPO.
Yeah.
That's it.
Exactly.
That's what I know. I need
yeah.
a PPO.
Yeah.
And I do not need an HMO. I need
yeah.
to walk into whatever insurance hospital I want to go into.
Right.
I need that.
Yes. Now, I know you also do some certified payroll. Did you want to talk a little bit about that?
Yes, I do. I've been very fortunate within these last 2 years to get in the construction market.
Yes.
And with that, there's a very specific need for payroll.
Yeah.
Certified payroll can be very tedious. Mm-hmm. It can not only keep business owners up at night or construction
okay.
owners up at night, but it can forbid them from getting paid on their projects.
Yes.
So I had the ability to partner with a great firm to help me produce the certified payroll reports.
And okay, if you don't mind, can you tell the
that's
audience
what I was about to say.
Certified
what,
payroll
what's
is?
The difference?
Okay, certified payroll just produces a payroll report.
Uh-huh.
And in that case, that report breaks down your wages, mm-hmm. your labor hours mm-hmm. per project,
okay.
And your taxes. And it has to be produced in the construction industry
okay.
weekly.
And it's usually prevailing wage.
Prevailing
and
wages.
A lot of construction firms, they don't know how to calculate prevailing wage. So you have to, if you're in the state of California, you have to go to the DIR,
mm-hmm.
which is the Department of Industrial Relations.
Right.
And they print you out a table.
Yes.
That tells you what each trade, what their prevailing wage is.
Yeah.
And
yes.
each one is different.
Yes. And it what happened was in the state of California, you had some huge contractors coming out of state. And obviously, they were paying their plumbers or their contractors
mm-hmm.
a certain wage.
Right.
And they were getting cheap labor somewhat.
Mm-hmm.
So we were able to come in, and the Davis-Bacon Act created a way that there is a certified wage for a particular job or for a particular trade.
Okay.
And those employers can either pay those wages out in cash or they can pay them out in benefits.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the certified payroll does. It breaks down those wages for cash labor, or if they're paying them out in health insurance
mm-hmm.
benefits or 401k benefits.
Okay, okay.
And the certified payroll is processed weekly.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of contractors don't know that. They
yes.
think because their regular payroll, the certified payroll is totally different than your regular
right.
payroll.
Yes.
So a lot of contractors believe that because they're paying their workers every 2 weeks, mm-hmm. then they should pay the certified payroll every 2 weeks. Uh-uh. No, it does not work that way. If you want to get in trouble, then don't pay weekly and pay every 2 weeks, and then you'll be in trouble.
Now, is there any other industry that benefits from this, or is this strictly for construction?
It is strictly for construction.
Awesome.
Construction.
Well, that's great, though. That's good, though.
So professional, and with certified payroll, it's only for your workers that's in the field, not the ones in the office.
Okay.
So the ones in the office, they get regular pay regular payroll every 2 weeks, but the certified payroll is done, and that's done based on prevailing wage. So how certified payroll is established is whenever you if you have at least $1,000 of government funds on a project, then you have to abide by certified payroll rules.
Okay.
And that's how it works.
Yeah, so for particular jobs, not every construction job is considered has to be process certified, but for a particular job, government jobs, school districts, things like that. So special projects.
That sounds good.
So before we take a break and bring on our next guest on the show, I just want you to tell us a little bit about you, Kunya, because a lot of us know you in the marketplace. We know what you've been doing, helping small business, how great you are. But a lot of people don't really know who Kunya is. So can you tell them a little bit about Kunya?
Sure. I was born and raised in Pasadena, California. I actually still reside there. So L.A. is home to me. Southern California is home to me. It's a special place in my heart.
She's my neighbor.
Yes.
That's what he really wanted you to say. He really wanted to tell them that she was his neighbor. Because that's what he wanted y'all to know.
I have the pleasure of being right down the street from Gilbert. Right. So, yes.
And most people don't really like to brag on themselves. So let me congratulate you for being. She actually received recognition from the state assembly for her work in financial services.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So the young lady is qualified to be on the show today. She studied business administration with the University of Laverne.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah,
why I wanted her to tell us a little.
And
bit
she's
about her.
Currently a part of the Presidents of Women Insurance and Financial Services.
Yes.
The Los Angeles chapter. That's impressive.
She's just modest. She doesn't want to say.
I helped her out a little bit.
Thank you, Nam. Appreciate that.
So what else do you want to tell us about yourself?
You know, I got into financial services in 2008 by default. I actually left the mortgage industry. So I worked for a huge lender, which still is a national lender. And after 2007, when the mortgage crashed, I got offered a nice opportunity to come and work for the city of Los Angeles doing supplemental benefits, disability benefits like AFLAC and retirement benefits. From there, I had the pleasure, and I say the pleasure, of bouncing around because I've gained so much knowledge and skill set. I was with Prudential.
Mm-hmm.
Prudential is a huge insurance carrier for 4 years, and that actually gave me the confidence and education to compete in the insurance industry. Mm-hmm. In 2015, I was recruited by a boutique payroll firm, and the owner brought me aboard to implement his employee benefits department. So he wanted to offer benefits to his clients, and in turn, I wanted to learn payroll. So it was a great exchange, and during that time, we actually bought out Apple One Payroll. A lot of people don't know Apple One had a small piece of payroll business.
Mm-hmm.
So I was very instrumental in that acquisition there, and I left the payroll firm in 2017, and I started my consulting practice. And I did that because payroll, there's no cookie cutter payroll product or payroll company for small businesses.
Mm-hmm.
So my goal is to create a peace of mind to those those needs that keep business owners up at night.
Right.
And she's a phenomenal businesswoman.
I believe that.
You know, I've met with her and we talked and we go over a lot of things that she's been doing and what she wants to do in the future with small business. And she's just phenomenal. So I know some people don't want to toot their own horn, but, you know, I don't mind tooting your horn for you.
Yes.
Thank you, Gilbert. I appreciate
that. Yes. And we're going to be teaming up and we're going to be working on some things as well. So,
yeah.
You'll be hearing a lot about Nick's Consulting.
Yes, please do. Gilbert and Crystal have been very, very influential and just keeping me going and, mm-hmm. And motivating me. And Gilbert is a great mentor. I am now working on my certifications and looking to get certified. Good. So good. He's been a great mentor to me yes. in that space, and excellent. I'm excited.
Excellent. And we need to do a follow-up meeting, so we'll schedule that and make sure you get those certifications that you need so you can take on bigger and better projects.
Absolutely.
What I want to do with many of my small businesses that I interface with is to get you guys, I want to get you government contracts. You know, there is a saying, I don't know if you guys know about Newton's law, and some people have heard of Newton's mm-hmm. law, Newton's mm-hmm. first law. It says, an object in motion always want to stay in motion.
Yes, absolutely.
If not obstructed. Mm-hmm. An object at rest always want to stay at rest.
Right.
Now, Buchanan's law is, a small business who has been established and is in operation wants to be successful. In order to be successful, you got to get government contracts. And that's what I want to do for small business. Many small businesses are doing transactional business. That means you do a business here, a business transaction here with a customer, one there, and you're not sure if that customer is coming back next week or next month. But if you have contract, if you're doing contracting business, then you get a contract for a year. That contract serves you. You know you've got that revenue coming in for a year, and then you start looking for additional contracts. And that's how I want small businesses to operate.
Absolutely.
So that's what we'll do. So, Cunha, thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you for having me. I feel like I made it now.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Business Zone, and we really appreciate having you here. So is there any parting words you want to share with our audience?
No, just keep your business needs in mind. Those things that are important to you. Payroll is like keeping your lights on. Mm-hmm. And don't run from it. Right. You know, approach it head on.
Right.
So there are people like myself out there to help you with those solutions and lean on them. And they're pretty cost effective. They can kind of save you a lot of money later on in the compliance world.
Right.
So. Don't do like me and Dawn. I'm running away from Dawn's fitness training. Run towards the payroll.
Run towards payroll. Too
Absolutely.
Funny. Too funny.
So you've been watching The Business Zone with?
Dawn Strozier.
Gilbert Buchanan and our very special guest.
Cunha Nix.
And we're going to go ahead and take a break right now, bringing on our next guest to tell you a little bit more about marketing.
Yes.
So let's take a break.
Hello, meet Larry. Larry is a general contractor. Larry is very good at his craft, but Larry has a very tough time managing his paperwork because he is busy taking care of his clients' needs. Larry just cannot find his important business documents when needed. Larry is also being passed over for bid opportunities from prime contractors because he is perceived as not ready. He doesn't know where his business license, certifications, insurance, and other key corporate documents are located most of the time. Lucy owns an auto body and collision repair shop and has been using a business management and procurement assistance program called Small Biz Pro to keep her business organized, business ready, contract ready, and bank loan ready. Small Biz Pro is a 3-in-1 cloud-based business management, procurement, and market research assistance system designed to help businesses become business ready, contract ready, and bank loan ready. It also provides back office operation solutions for small businesses. Lucy is able to stay ahead of her competitors because she uses Small Biz Pro to manage her business daily. Lucy just clicks on Small Biz Pro from her tablet, mobile phone, laptop, or any internet-accessible device for data retrieval, and she's got it. Lucy introduces Larry to Small Biz Pro, and now Larry is more organized and can now find all of his documents and new bid opportunities in seconds. Larry now saves $120 in labor costs for each missing or misplaced document. Just simply go to your web browser and log into smallbizpro.net and register today for a limited 30-day free trial offer. Services start as low as $1 per day. Let's put the competition out of business. Small Biz Pro. If you stay ready, you don't need to get ready. Register now at smallbizpro.net and begin saving money. Email info@smallbizpro.net or call 626-533-1186.
Excellent. Are you contract ready? Are you bank loan ready?
So I want to know how business ready you guys are.
Part of what we want to do is to match you up with contract providers in Vegas, the casinos.
We put together this training for the contractors in Las Vegas to assist them in becoming business ready.
You know, when you first start a small business, the thing you're shortest on is resources. So the association is actually providing the training for.